So in this lecture, we are going to cover some important points regarding cause-effect graph. And the different topics which we are going to cover is where and all cause-effect graph is applicable, what are its limitations, how to provide coverage for cause-effect graph, and what are the different type of defects which you can find. So let's start with the first topic, where and all it is applicable. To start with test levels. It is applicable at integration level, system level, and acceptance level. You can see here that the component level is missing. And the answer for that is, depending on the code, it may also be applicable for component testing. So it totally depends upon your code. If your code contains decision logic, then only you can apply cause-effect graph at component level. If there is no decision logic, then you cannot apply. But in these three levels, you can apply. So that is what you need to understand here. The next very important point is, cause-effect graph is useful when the requirements are presented in the form of flowcharts or tables of business rules. If you have a requirement and if that requirement can be represented in the form of flowchart or table, then only a cause-effect graph is an effective technique. Otherwise, not. Now let's see some basic points regarding the cause-effect graph which we have drawn. So a cause-effect graph shows what all things this cause-effect graph can show. First thing is, condition combinations that cause results. So here you can see that there are different conditions. When they were fulfilled, we were achieving this result, that is approved transaction. So condition combination that causes result. Next one is condition combination that exclude results. Now if I have to exclude this result, then my account should not be real account and it should not be active. Then we will call the call vendor. So that is how we can exclude the results also by providing different combinations. Third point is multiple conditions that must be true to cause a result. So in order to approve the transaction, these are the multiple conditions which has to be true. So that is the meaning of third point. Fourth point is alternative conditions that must be true to cause a particular result. If we see call card holder here, these two conditions has to be true, whereas the next two conditions are false, and then we are resulting in this combination or this result. So this is the meaning of these four points. Now let's see what are the limitations when we talk about cause-effect graph. The first one is you need additional time. Cause-effect graphing requires additional time and effort to learn compared to the other test design technique. It takes more time, it takes more effort. This is the first point. The second point is, sometime you also require a tool support in order to draw the call effect graph. Next point is particular notations. So there are certain rules which we need to follow when we are drawing a cause effect graph, so that the creator can understand and whoever is reading can understand what is the meaning of this cause effect graph. So it is very important that everyone has to follow a particular notation. So this also comes under limitations. If you don't know the notation, then you cannot read the graph. And the last point with respect to limitation is limited inputs. So the input should be in a particular format, that is functional logic. It should be a user story or a flowchart. Then only you can apply these techniques, otherwise not. So these were the four limitations. Additional time and effort you need tool, particular notations are required, and very limited inputs. So now let's move to the coverage. So if you have this type of cause-effect graph, then how you can see how much you have covered. So the formula for coverage is number of condition tested. So you have different conditions here. How many conditions you have tested and what are the total number of combinations. So if there is a decision table, it is very easy to find out because we have seen 9 combinations, and if you test only one, then it will be 1 divided by 9 into 100. So coverage is nothing but how many test cases you have tested out of it and how many test cases you had. By calculating or by providing all the numbers here, you can calculate the coverage. Moving to the last point, what are the different type of defects you can find? The first point is defects in document. Defect may be found in the specification document because it requires lots of analysis. Without analyzing, you cannot draw a cause-effect graph. And while analyzing, it is more likely that you will find the defect. The second point is defect in flow, because cause-effect graph is nothing but showing the flow of the program. So if there is any problem with the flow, then you can find it out. Incorrect processing based on particular combinations of conditions resulting in unexpected result. So if you have different combinations which is resulting in some other result, you can find it out using a cause-effect graph. The next one is defect type. Omissions and contradictions. If one condition is telling something else and other condition is telling something else, then such type of defects you can find. If for some combinations, if you don't have any result, that also you can find. That is nothing but omissions. So omissions and contradictions in the requirement, you can find it out. The last one is defect in conditions. So condition combinations that are not handled or are not handled well can be found out by using a cause-effect graph, because here we are checking the combinations itself. So if the combinations, certain combinations are not handled, we can find it out. So these are the four type of defects. Defect in the specification, defect in the flow, omissions and contradictions, and conditions. And with this, we are ending this lecture, and I will see you with the next one. Until then, happy testing.